Hey everyone, it's David. I'm back again. I'm making another video. What I'd like to talk to you about is lubricants, chain oil for your bicycle. People have questions like, which is the best chain oil for you to use? Well, it depends. It depends if the weather. If you live in a dry place, if you live in a place where it rains, if there's different type of oils. So for me, I really don't know what the best one is. So what I did was I bought three popular ones that I use. And instead of, I'll tell you a little bit about each one. And I'll give you my story, and then you can figure out what oil is best for you. So let's talk about TriFlow. I bought this actually pretty recently, about a month ago. I've never used it before, but I'm going to make this video because I want to actually show you the labels on each of them and maybe do a little sample to show you what it looks like. So this is TriFlow, and we'll just read it together. Superior lubricant formulated with PTFE. I don't know what that is. Okay. And it's also in Spanish as well. Okay. It's 2 fluid ounces. Now, all these are 2 fluid ounces. That's what I learned today by putting them all together. And then we'll also go in the back here. Shake well. Oh, I didn't even do that, so I'll shake well next time. And wipe away the accumulated stuff and grit. Okay. And it contains some stuff that doesn't look so good and some warnings. Keep out of harm's way of children. Now, why did I get this one? Well, I do get my bike serviced from time to time, mostly my brakes. I do have a Brompton bicycle. It's a folding bicycle. And I was talking to the mechanic there because maybe once a year, maybe twice a year, I'll bring it in for just an inspection and also to replace the brake pads. And he said, oh, yeah, put a little bit of TriFlow over here and over here. And he pointed out some places where I should use TriFlow. So he used the word TriFlow. I was like, oh, okay. So I went online. I went to the internet. And this was about $5. So what's good about this TriFlow is it comes with like a little straw. So you open it up and you just drip it on with the straw, and you can get to those hard-to-reach places. So far, it's been pretty good. I really don't know the difference between them all, but that one's pretty good. So we'll go to the second one here. I think I got this one in from Camp Moore, which is located in Paramus, New Jersey. It's sort of like a biking and camping and outdoor place, but they do have like a little bicycle section. So this one is finish line dry, has Teflon, all riding conditions. Again, this is a 2 ounce bottle. And basically the purpose of this video is also we're just reading the directions, we're reading the labels. I know that you guys can make an educated decision about which is your best, which lube you should use. So this one has Teflon. Okay, shake well, wipe off the excess, and this contains hepatine something. And they also, this is interesting, they have a 1-800 number here. And it's, I guess on Long Island there is where it's distributed from. There's a website here from the UK. Okay, here we go. Finishlineusa.com. Green. Okay. This is actually the first time I actually read this. So there you go. This is Finish Line Dry. And let's talk about this one. Of course, when you're have a lot of time at work and you're just goofing around, you'll probably go to some forums to find out what is the best loop. So I think I've been using this a lot. I bought this, if I remember, from an REI store in Paramus, REI. It's like an outdoor store, Paramus, New Jersey. And what I like about them is to actually go see all the little bottles. I think they have like the largest selection of chain lubes, like chain oil, all in one place. So you actually can get to see it up close and touch the bottles and see what it's all about. So this is what it is, Dumonde Tech Light Chain Lube. Improves shifting and chain life, blah 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 blah. Reduces chain noise. And let's see if it has any warnings here. Now use while smoking, eating, or drinking. Okay, combustible. Okay, using well ventilated. Interesting. This one doesn't have any. And it's just distributed by HGNR. I never knew that. Oh, and there's a website here too. And I'll put this in the video as well. It's HGNR.com. Doesn't tell you what type of stuff that's in here at all. Now you can see that I used a lot of it. This one I probably used the most. And for me, what I do is my total weekly riding is 250 miles. And then on the weekends, usually on Sunday, I give my bike a bath and I chain it. My bike doesn't, so every week I put a little bit of oil. I think last year I used this one, but this year I'm going to be using TriFlow just to see what the difference is. And I usually can't tell at all because I really can't tell because every week I oil it. But with having three of these, I keep one. Actually, I keep this one in my car, in the trunk of the car. So before I ride, if I need something, I'll just put a dab on. And this one goes in my, like in my work area or my garage. And then this one I keep, this is my newest one. So I keep this one in my work area as well. So I just wanted to show you what type of chain oils are out there. This actually I got mail ordered. I got this on eBay and it was about $5.07 or something like that. Came my door. It was a USA shipper. Really nice. Once again, I got this at Campmore, which is a really nice place to get tents and sleeping bags, and they have a bicycle section. And then this I got at in Paramus, New Jersey, too, at the REI store. So there's three. So hopefully you learned something. The answer is I don't know. I have these three. I've been trying them out myself, and there's no best one because I lube, like I clean my chain and all that stuff once a week anyway. So thanks for watching my video. Talk to you later. Bye.